What's going on, everyone? It's Josie from Edge. Today we're going to be learning about another adventure here about our faith. So sit back at home and get ready for another adventure in the Catholic Church. We have been talking this semester, you guys might have already guessed by now, about how to be a saint, how to live our universal call to holiness. Today we're going to understand how we can be a saint by loving God with our entire mind. You see, we are made in the image of God, and in this radical pursuit of Him, we are pilgrims on a journey. We are searching for things good, true, and beautiful. Throughout our entire life, we have an ordered desire to search these things. In this way, we are constantly searching for answers by asking questions. By questioning things, we are understanding that truth lies not within ourselves, but in an exterior place. Truth, we know as Christians, has a name. It is God Himself. Now you see, in this pursuit of truth, we discover a relationship between our minds and reality, that which really and truly is. This is a constant process of discovery throughout our entire life. As St. Augustine says, our hearts are truly restless, O Lord, until they rest in You. Now you see, all truth comes from God, and our minds are pointed towards finding it. For us as Catholics and Christians, truth is more than just an object. You see, it is a person. It is the Holy Trinity, one God. Our mission then is to find God through our mind, that is, using our intellect to pursue truth as a person. I'd like to suggest a couple of ways that we can come to love God more and more through our mind. You see, to love God with our mind is the highest form of thought. What then are some of the ways that we can find truth? Well, the first one I'd like to suggest to you is Scripture. Truth, we know, is a person, and that person has spoken to us. This spoken word of God is called the Bible, or the Scriptures. You see, if God is truth, and the word of God is from Him, then the word is truth itself. So let's challenge ourselves to become more familiar with understanding the Scriptures. We should know the ways in which God speaks to us through them. You see, the Bible is more than simply listening to it at Mass or at a church service. Now, of course, that is a good, beautiful, and true thing. But ultimately, it is more than just this. We can use the Scriptures to come into a personal relationship with Jesus Christ Himself. Ultimately, reading the Scriptures is a process of relationship building with Christ, with God, the Father, with the Holy Spirit. As we read the Scriptures then, not simply as a study project, but it is truly a conversation with truth Himself. So let's challenge ourselves to do that. Now, the second way I'd like to suggest is by our schoolwork. You see, we ought to pursue sanctity, our role to become a saint, in every role that we have in our life. Right now, we are called to be students, living as saints to build the kingdom of God. So some other roles you may have is being a brother or sister, a friend, a son or daughter. Now, all of these are important and are beautiful things. But we can't overlook the importance of being a student in this particular state of life right now. We have a responsibility to leave each state of life to its very fullest potential. Being a student, of course, is particularly related to the life of the mind. And using our mind to its fullest capabilities is one of the greatest gifts that God offers us. Our role then as students is closely tied to the pursuit of truth Himself. By taking school seriously, by completing our academic responsibilities, we are living our purpose in loving God more and more with our mind. Now, the third way that we can love God more and more with our mind is with greater self-awareness, or as the saints of past would call it, an examine. You see, if truth is only in our mind and it is not lived out in our deeds, it is of little good to us. We need to allow that truth to transform our very actions and our choices in order to conform to the will of God. Humans are not just mind, but they are also not just heart. Our heart and our actions need to be guided by the truth that is within our mind, towards a life of virtue and love. Good actions begin with good thoughts, and good actions point towards a new person as defined by moral activity. This is called an examined life. So I would suggest that we examine our life more by thinking about our choices, our actions, and the consequences of those actions. When we examine ourselves before God, with our mind, with our heart, with our entire being,
We can thank him for the gifts he has given us, and we can ask him to help show in our actions how we may manifest his love. So let's go ahead and conclude some of our main points that we spoke about today in our conversation. Life, you see, is a constant process of discovery towards the eternal things, towards the good, the true, and the beautiful, ultimately towards God himself. Today, we discussed how to love God with all of our mind. We do this by pursuing truth, by looking at how we can apply that pursuit of truth, firstly to the scriptures, to building a personal relationship with Jesus Christ himself. Next, we covered how our lives as students can be turned towards loving God with all of our mind, how we can love God with joy and with love in each of our academic responsibilities. And lastly, we understood the importance of living a moral and examined life in order to be good people, good Christians, good sons and daughters of the King. Ultimately, let us conform our mind. Let's use our mind towards the good of the church, towards our universal call to holiness, and follow the example of the saints who have come before us in praising and honoring our God and King with all of our heart, all of our soul, our strength, and in this day, our mind.